doing a quick, well, I don't know if you call it a review, but it's maybe if you have a question, should you get a battery tester? You know, if you check your battery once in a while, you do a bit of DIY on your own vehicles, then in my opinion, should you have one of these? A definite 100% yes. This is the brand I have. It can be any brand that you like, really. They're all pretty generic and probably the same product, only just a different name. I've had this for, well, quite some time, and I use it once a year to check my batteries in the wintertime because this thing can save you from being stranded. It really can. It's a simple device, but I'll explain it. Maybe you already know it, but maybe somebody that's watching this video don't, and that's why they're watching this video. So what you have is, this one is for a 6 or 12 volt. So right here, you'll see the 6 volt, and it only goes up to that whole K right here. So from there to there is the 6 volt. The 12 volt is on the bottom. As you see, it's this. Now with the 12 volt, this thing can check your voltage. It can check your alternator to see if your alternator is running okay. And it checks your cranking amps. Right here is, it even tells you like the minimum crank volt. So say your battery is, can you see down there? Say it's 11 whatever point, whatever volts. Well, it tells you your load volts. When you hit this button to put a load on this heating element in here, the same thing as in your electric stove or toaster, it should read, at the minimum it should read is what it says here. So since we can only see the 11 volt, let's go with 11 volts. So you should get at least minimum 9.7 volts. So it should be like right here, if you got 11 volt battery, if your battery is reading 11 volts, if that makes sense. So what we'll do is we're going to connect the positive, and man, so cold out there, the wires won't even bend there. What do we got? What do we got? We have, since this battery was actually on the maintainer, you're going to have some surface charge there. So it's almost a 14, which you can see it dropping right now. Anyway, then on your battery, you're going to, whatever your battery is, cold cranking amps 590, cranking amps 740. Now, to my understanding, how that was explained to me is, you have the two temperature ranges. This would be the cold cranking amps, and that's the one I'm concerned about, simply because it's winter time and it's cold as a witch's elbow. So what we're going to do, we know that we got good volts on this battery, okay? Now what we're going to do is push this button, put a load on this element, and we're going to hold it for 10 seconds, as you can read here. Then we're going to see, remember, we went with 11 volt, but we got more. So it should be around 10 or even 10 and a half. But you get the idea on the quick check of your condition of your battery. So we're going to put a load on this now and count to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And we're at 600, which is good because we want 590. And we're at 11. 11 volts is what we had with the load. So we know, right? We know that we're well in the spec here. Minimum voltage on a load, we're good. So we got 600 cranking amps our battery said 590, we're good. It's a good way to heat up your hands too, to warm them up. Anyway, that's the simple version of how this thing works. So, do you think you need one? Well, if you check your own battery at all and maintain your work on your vehicles, then yeah, this thing can save you from being stranded, you know. If your battery is weak, you think it's weak, you can check it. Once again, you can check your cranking amps, you can check your voltage, you can even check your alternator when it's running. Start your vehicle with the battery in it, obviously, stick your negative positive on, and this will tell you if your alternator is good. If it falls in the okay, then you're good. So there's a lot of things that you can check with your battery on this thing. For the price, go ahead, get yourself one. All right, don't have to be that brand, but get yourself one. You'll thank yourself. It might set in your toolbox for months and months and months, and you'll never use it, but it's nice every winter to, especially older vehicles, it's good to check your battery. Like I said, it could save you from being stranded. Take care, guys. Hit the subscribe button.